Hey Jude, don't make it bad. Take a sad song and make it better. Remember to let her into your heart. Then you can start to make it better.
Hey first partner, I was pregnant with Jude. Gosh, end of 2005, brother or sister for Travis, and he was thrilled at the idea of that, and we later found out that we were having a little boy, and he was just overjoyed that it was a brother and not a sister. The first time we thought there was a problem, we went for a scan, for our 12-week scan. I was told at that scan that I had an amniotic band, which I'd never heard of, and nobody could actually tell me or talk to me about it for possibly about 4 to 6 weeks because the consultant was on his holidays and it was rare and nobody knew anything about it.
We went to Harley Street and spoke to a doctor at Harley Street, Donald Gibb, and he done a scan and reassured us that the bands were making no difference to Jude's growth and everything was fine at that point, and that was at 30 weeks.
I felt perfectly normal through the whole pregnancy. Didn't have any sickness, didn't have anything, felt healthy, just really good. Jude, don't be afraid. You were made to... When we first realised there was a problem, was when I woke up one morning on my left-hand side, and throughout my entire pregnancy, Jude had never let me lay on my left-hand side. He would always kick me and wiggle, and within seconds I would instantly know that he wanted me to move. So when I woke up that morning on my left side, I first thing I thought was that was very strange, but never occurred to me there was a problem. I just moved onto my back and held my tummy and waited for him to sort of wake up with me. And we went to the hospital and we're just expecting to be told everything's fine, you know, just go home, it's okay, you'll have your baby soon. We saw a midwife who listened to my stomach and she couldn't hear anything. And it was at that point that I could sense that kind of initial panic coming over me. So she went to get the ultrasound and she still couldn't find a heartbeat. And that's when she just sort of told us that our baby had died. I didn't believe it to start with. I thought she was wrong. She had to be wrong, because in my pregnancy everything had been pretty normal. I'd done everything by the book. I'd been like as good as you could be when you're sort of nurturing a child. That she had to be wrong, you know. I thought I would have known if he'd died, you know. It just didn't sit comfortably with me, but I think I just didn't want to believe it.
So Lynn was given a tablet to take to induce the pregnancy, and we went home on Thursday, and the following morning Lynn went into labour. We went into hospital.
And even at that point, even though I knew that I hadn't felt him move, I still somewhere believed that this was just all ridiculous and that it would be perfectly all right. And just then being taken into a special room for parents who have to give birth to stillborn children.
Lynn gave birth to Jude, and I think I'd been relatively strong up until that point, and I kind of broke down and didn't deal with it or cope with it very well.
Until I saw him and held him for myself, I was always clinging on to that little bit of hope that he'd still cry.
but I always remember how nice a day it was, and that, you know, beautiful sunny summer's day, and I was sitting with my stillborn son in my arms, and I couldn't have cared less about anything else in the world at that point. Probably the most 24 hours of my life.
The hospital afterwards was appalling, really. It was almost as though, right, well, that's happened. We can't do anything now. We just need to get you home and just move you on, really. We were handed to another lady, I suppose, a kind of grief counsellor, who was just very patronising, didn't really understand at all, sent us home with a leaflet, and that was it. That was all the help we had. We held him, and I held him close, probably still in my heart of hearts, thinking that he would take a breath, but and he just looked perfectly normal, perfect little boy. And then we were allowed to sort of hold him and spend as much time as we wanted with him.
When we lost Jude, we felt that there was no counselling. There's a leaflet, read it. Don't worry about it, you can always have another baby. I had a business partner that actually turned round to me, an ex-business partner, who turned round to me and said, you know, tell Lynn to get over it, people have been through worse. But that is the perception. You know, people that don't have children, the general public, 6,500 babies dying every year in this country, and nobody talks about it.